Are you trying to figure out how to record the screen on your iPhone? Maybe it's a quick demonstration of an application. Maybe it's navigation of a certain website. Whatever it may be, you want to record it quickly and share it. Well, this guy, Kevin Kolbe, he did the research, found 9 different applications, but 3 that work the best. Keep watching to find out what. Hey there, it's Alex with your local studio, and I have with me Kevin with Kevin Kolbe Media. He did the research, 22 minutes over a Jimmy John's sub, and found there were how many apps on the App Store?
We found 9.
9 apps. Yeah. And there were how many that you loved the most?
Only 3.
3! 3 made the cut. What were the 3?
Record It, DU Recorder, and the one that actually comes already installed on your iPhone.
Oh. Already built in.
Yeah,
I love it. And if you download these apps, it's simple as swiping up?
To use the apps, yeah, on it's called the control center on your phone, but if you swipe up from the bottom, doesn't matter whether the phone's locked or unlocked, there's gonna be a round button, and that's where you can activate any of the apps you have installed.
Whether it's the built-in one or one of the other ones,
yeah.
You can select it and start recording.
If you hold it down long enough, a window pops up and you can scroll and say, oh, that's the one I want, click it, and you can start recording from right there.
Now you can jump in and just start using it right now, but if you'd like to hear what about them he liked the most, keep listening. First, I want to know actually, why didn't you like the other 6?
Well, the one thing I will say, they were all free. That's great.
Free is good.
Some of them had in-app purchases, which means there were just constant banner ads being served up over and over
ads.
That would interrupt the process. One of them wanted me to register before I could even look at it. And there was another one that was just too complicated, even though I kind of got it, to just walk through the steps. So I went for simplicity, and that's why these 3 jumped to the top.
Free, simple, easy to use.
Yep. Yeah.
We like that.
Yeah.
All right, so let's dig into those 3. What about them did you like? What are the particular use cases for each 3? Because maybe you use one over another for a different purpose.
And they're all a little different. So Record It is free, but it does have a $3.99 upgrade. Mm-hmm. And looking at the upgrade, you don't need it. I don't think you don't need it.
Nice.
I wouldn't buy it. And there didn't seem to be any limitations like on a lot of apps.
So you can keep using it, don't have to worry about
it. Keep using it. Very simple. You hit record. It will allow you to do something like almost like a picture-in-picture where you could bring in a video from your library, something like that, and be doing a video over that. You can do narration. The one problem with this one and most of the apps is if you're narrating, you're doing a voiceover over a video, say, on your camera roll already, it doesn't adjust the level.
So if it's a really loud video, you may not be able to hear your narration.
Yeah.
So
there's some
limited editing abilities, but simple.
Very simple to use. You hit record. It's going to record. When you're done, it loads to the app, to the library, and it's pretty much that simple.
So you can record your face, the screen, and narration. Awesome.
Yep. Right,
let's go over the recorder.
This one, the first time I saw it, I almost didn't download it because they advertise it as a way to live stream and also screen capture. And I thought, well, that's not what I'm really interested in. Once I got into it and started playing with it, it's actually really smart. Now, again, it's totally free, but it's got the same screen capture where you can do your screen recording, rather, and things like that. But you can also live stream your phone directly to Twitch, Facebook, and YouTube.
Wow. So you can do like a live demonstration of an app or using your new website straight to Facebook.
Right.
And narrate over at the same time.
Right. And it had some other built-in options too. After you've recorded it, it saves the video to the app, but then you can go in and you can edit, you can trim, you can add filters, you can add text, and you can even create a GIF from your video up to 30 seconds.
Fascinating. So if you want to quickly show a demonstration of a certain section and then embed that GIF on a website, that use case.
Right.
Wow. So if you need a lot of editing capability, not a lot, but if you want to quickly edit and do something with it, whether it's broadcast or share it, that's a good tool to have.
Yeah. And it saves it all within the app. And you just said something I think is important to point out. If you're not used to using these a lot of them, the buttons, instead of record, it says start broadcasting. And the important thing to remember is you're not really broadcasting. Mm-hmm. I think of broadcasting as I'm going live, I'm going to live stream. This is all about recording it onto your phone.
Mm.
So don't let that throw you.
When you press that button, don't be afraid of the broadcast.
Yeah.
Though that particular app does also allow you to broadcast.
Yes, it does.
Okay.
To confuse you even more.
Now, the last one, the built-in, you like it.
Yes, and for a lot of reasons. One, obviously, it's free with the price of your phone, right? But you have to have ISO 11 or later, but it's there. and it works. It's very simple. When you hit record, it goes 3, 2, 1. It's a silent countdown, and it records anything on your screen, as most of these do, including showing you that app, and it's going to immediately save it to your camera roll. The other thing I liked about it is when you stop recording, it immediately gives you a notification. Recording has stopped, and it saves it to your camera roll. You can even hit the notification, and it will take you right to that clip. It really can't be any easier.
Nice. So if you just need a quick, simple recording to share it via an email or something else, that may be the best.
Yeah.
And if you need a bit more editing capabilities, DU recorder,
yeah.
might be better.
Yeah. And the other thing, too, is that you can edit the one that comes with the phone, but it's very limited. It's like trimming a clip, or you can launch it on iMovie. That's about all. You would have to take it to another program. So it might not be the best one if you want to do more, but if you just want something like quick and easy, you got it.
Simply swipe up and hit that recording button.
Right.
Well, thank you for sharing the research. Hope you guys find this helpful. Leave a comment below. We'd love to hear maybe another application that you found really helpful. Share what it is, why you liked it, why you didn't like it. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks, guys. See you next time.